Hello everybody. It's been about 9 days since my last video. I added nutrients 2 days after that video. It was on a Thursday, I think. Or no, it was on a Wednesday. It was on a Thursday. I don't know, man. And then so here's an update video. These guys are gonna be traveling Friday and today's a Wednesday. This is the Thai basil that was dying and like flaking up. All the leaves were falling off of. And as you can see, it's bushed out and recovered splendidly. This is the kale that I've had since the beginning. And to be honest, I've never eaten from this, and I was just seeing how much it can grow. As you can see, there's a lot of branching off right here. But the plants keep doing this. It's like crispy and crunchy. And there's this weird. Yeah, there's like this weird coloring on it. And then I checked last night and the water level's pretty low and there's like this white gunk growing on the roots. So I'm just gonna throw the whole thing away and I don't have to travel with it. This is the golden harvest that rooted a little bit after being plucked out and broken. And it has a tiny green baby in there, right there. And that one's from the back. And there's flowers growing on it, but I do want to transfer it once I arrive home with it. And then here's the other golden harvest that as you can see, it's a lot less now. And I don't know if it is, but there's been some white powdery mildew looking thing on it, and I just removed some of the leaves. Hopefully it doesn't come back, but we don't know. And I harvested most of the tomatoes off and threw them in a pasta sauce. And then it's growing. It's got four that I can see right now. Five, actually. That one's like stuck in there. And then I need to like prune it a little bit. And this is the red one that was falling over like crazy. And I took most of the red tomatoes off. They've developed in the last week, these ones. They weren't red before. And then I took off a lot of leaves, so it's no longer falling over. And it exploded with bountifulness. I don't know. Once I got rid of the leaves and some of the redder tomatoes. It's really cute because they grow in bunches, which I guess makes sense. So it was really fun to like pick off a whole bunch of them. And then here is the harvest. Hold on, let me raise the lights. This here is the beautiful yellow chard. Chard? Chard. I'm gonna call it chard. And then the red chard is in there. It's falling over. All of these are kind of falling over because they're kind of heavy. But look how huge this leaf is. It's just enormous. And then here's the three tiny bok choys. Oh, that one got ripped when I was handling it. Here's the kale liberation kale mix. I don't know why, but my plants keep on doing this. I don't know if it's right before I add nutrients or right after I add nutrients. It's either too much nutrients or too little nutrients. But the kale tend to have that happen to them every time around nutrient adding time. Here's the bok choy that's always doing wonderfully. And then here's the kale mix from the original Aerogarden. And the bok choy over there keeps on like just encroaching on everybody else's space. And then the spinach I took out, so right now there's just something blocking the hole, so there's no light getting into the water. And yeah, I'm gonna harvest this later and use it in cooking. And I've been using this new nutrient. Ignore that. It's a powder, and I've just been doing it. Comes with a scoop that has one side is a little scoop, one side is a big scoop, and I've been doing two little scoops and putting it into this Target jug of water. I do warm water so it would melt, and I did this nutrients this last week, but then I've just been doing this the previous time since I got this. And then in between, if I'm filling up the water, I do the water with the powder in it. And I do think that's why these things are like growing so well and so quickly. Yep, that's my update. Happy Halloween and have a good whatever. Bye.